Hi, my name is Kristen Navara. I'm a faculty member in poultry science, and I work primarily on endocrinology. Stress and reproductive hormones are my favorite. Well, primarily sex is, of course, determined by what sex chromosomes you inherit. But it appears that it's a lot more complicated because, specifically in birds, it appears that the social context and triggers and environmental triggers, social triggers, can actually influence whether a female donates a W or a Z chromosome and influence the ultimate sex that she produces. And so that opens a huge range of things that we need to be looking at to understand why a female produces a male or a female, and ultimately, maybe how to control that. When we knew that females were able to adjust sex ratios according to environmental conditions, our first thought was, well, what is the hormone that responds to those environmental conditions? And that's stress hormones. And so we believe that those stress hormones were what were mediating this effect on sex ratios. And it's particularly important because we have these two strains of chickens. We have layer flocks and we have broiler flocks. And in each one, it's very important whether you're male or female. Layer chicks need to be female to lay eggs. And broiler chicks need to be male because those are the only ones who produce enough meat to be lucrative to raise. Of course, that's what we eat. And so the poultry industry would love it if we could produce a flock, all females for the layer side and all males for the broiler side. And that's what we're working on. We know that female birds in the wild have this amazing ability to alter the sexes of their offspring without our help. And so we want to harness that mechanism so that we could use it potentially in the industry to create the sexes that we need for those different industries. So right now in the short term, we're trying to find a treatment simply because we know that the birds have this ability, and we know that they have this ability in response to the hormonal treatments that we've been giving them. The problem with using hormones, though, is that in the poultry industry, you are not allowed to use hormones. It is banned by the FDA. So any treatment that we use in the industry has to be a non-hormonal treatment. So what we're trying to do now is to use our hormones to elicit the effects that we want, and then go a step further and figure out what genes those hormones are turning on and off. Once we figure that out, we can develop a non-hormonal treatment that can be used in the poultry industry to get the effects that we want to see.